Today, Adobe released a brand new captioning workflow inside of Premiere Pro. Let's go ahead and take a look to see how it works. Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today, if you update to the latest version of Premiere Pro 15.0 from Adobe Creative Cloud, you will now see that the captioning panel is gone. There is a brand new captioning workflow that allows you to edit and create captions using the text panel. There's now a track dedicated to captions in the timeline so you can treat your captions like video clips. You can select them and stylize them inside of the essential graphics panel, which is so much better than the previous workflow. And of course, you can see a preview of your captions as you stylize them from the program monitor. So this captioning workflow has been tested in the public beta, and now it's available in version 15.0. I recommend finishing the project that you're currently working on before you update to 15.0. It's just a good practice to have as video editors because you don't want to mix up the different versions when you're working on a current project. So what's the outline for this tutorial? First, I'm going to show you how to create the captions, and there's many different ways that you can do it, so I'll go through each different one. And of course, I will talk about the status of the speech-to-text program and how you can get involved with the transcription inside of Premiere Pro. It's not yet available yet, but we'll talk about that. And then I'll show you how to edit the captions, stylize them, and finally how to export it and also save the captions as a SRT file that you can attach to videos. But I'll be showing you the difference between a burn-in caption and a closed captioning file. So, per usual, the time codes are just down below, so if you wanna click around to review, or you can always pause to slow it down, take it slow. All right, let's go ahead and jump on in. Captions, when to create them. Right now, for all of social media, if you're making videos for Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, all of those I would recommend to have burned in captions when people are talking. It just makes it more accessible. So that way if people are, you know, late at night, they don't want to wake up somebody, they don't want to use headphones, they can read your video and understand what's happening without having the volume on. And it makes it accessible to people that are differently abled. So definitely make sure to consider doing the burned in captions. On YouTube, however, it's a little bit different. Most people have the sound on, and this is why I recommend just uploading a captioning file or just editing the built-in captions. So you have the CC. And the only difference between burned in and closed captions is the burned in you can't remove, right? And closed captions, the way I remember it, is that you can close them. Closed captions. You don't have to have them open all the time. So YouTube, closed captions, other social media platforms, I recommend burning it in. And so when do you make the captions? I recommend waiting until you finish your video edit to add the captions, because if you make changes later on, you'll have to go and manually change all of the captions. So wait just before export to add your captioning track. So now let's go into how to create them. Creating captions. First, make sure that you're in the captions workspace by clicking on the captions button here at the top of the Premiere Pro window. This will pull up the text panel on the left. And from here, you're given three different options to create captions. The first option is transcribe the sequence, which right now is only available to the closed beta for the speech to text users. And essentially what it does, it'll auto transcribe your sequence for you, or a particular audio track in your sequence, and then you can use that as a starting point to edit from. Now, Adobe says that they plan to release the speech to text to the public later this year. I don't know when yet, but you can definitely find out more about how to apply to the speech to text program by clicking up above. You can click on the card. I made a full video already on how it works. And the second way here is to create your own captions manually, where you can go through and manually type them out. So to show how this manual captioning track works, I've created a sample video project, just a little 15-second video, my voiceover, and I use some stock video clips, music, and sound effects. And all of those effects and assets in this video are from Videvo. And Videvo, what's great about it is they have thousands of free assets that you can download and use in any project that you want. Each asset that you find there, it actually shows you the licensing details, so you can see what it's safe to use for. And more often than not, all of them are safe for YouTube, for any type of platform that you're looking to create for. So it's really creator friendly. And if you want access to the premium assets, you can sign up for one of their premium plans. And Videvo, they set up a code for you, GAL15, to get 15% off any of those plans that you can choose from. So thank you, Videvo, for setting that up and providing the footage. You can download the sample project file to caption along with me, so you can check that out in the description box below. So if you go to the manual route, here I recommend using the subtitle format, as this is typically used for burning captions into your video, which is also known as open captions. So I wouldn't worry about the rest of the different closed captioning options here, the different formats, because those are very specific. They're not for social media. If you ever want to know what they are, you can always just Google it and find out what it's used for. So now here, you can just click up here to create a new segment, and then you can manually type out what is spoken. So you'll listen back to the video and manually type it out. And you'll see that it makes a captioning track in the timeline. And here's where you can move the captions into place, and it will update the timing inside of the text panel when you move the captioning clips, which is super useful. And once you make your captions and you're completely done, if you want to save it as a .srt file so you can attach it to your YouTube or Facebook videos, just select the ellipses here and export as a .srt. So manually creating the captions takes a lot of time. You have to watch back the video and manually type it in. Well, if you don't have access to the speech-to-text program that will auto-transcribe your captions for you, how do you then import a captioning file, import a .srt file from which you can stylize and burn them into the video? So a quick hack that you can use is using Facebook. So Facebook has really, really fast auto-generated captions that are pretty accurate. It does require a little bit of tweaking, but it saves you time because you don't have to manually type it out, right? So first of all, let's go back to the manual track that we created. Let's right-click on it and let's delete it. You'll also see some other options here where you can actually add another track. So if you want to have translated captions on top of English captions, let's say, you can have two captioning tracks at once, which is super useful. But for now, let's go ahead and delete the manual track. Once the captioning track is deleted, what you're going to do is just export a clean .mp4 file without any captions or anything. So once it's exported as its own MP4 file, you're going to upload it to Facebook. Don't worry, you don't have to publish it. All we're going to do is go to the captioning tab and then select auto-generate the captions. And Facebook will listen to your video and convert your voice to text. And then you'll probably have to go in and make a few edits because it's not perfect. And then once Facebook has processed the video, you can then download the .srt file. If you don't want to go the free route, let's say it's a really long video and maybe you don't want to use Facebook or YouTube, there's actual services out there like rev.com where you can pay per minute a human to actually transcribe and create the captions for you. And you know, it's pretty decently priced. I think it's like $1.25 per minute. There's also translation services, but there is a 24-hour turnaround time, sometimes even longer. So keep that in mind. That's another way of getting the .srt file. So once you have the .srt file, let's go ahead and go back into Premiere Pro. So here, let's go ahead and select Import Captions from File. Then from Format, select Subtitle. The style section, let's leave that for now. I'll cover that in just a minute. And for the start, let's select the timeline start. And once it's imported, you'll see that there's now a captioning track with all the captions there. You can always select all the captions and move them to line them up better with the voice. Let's say it didn't perfectly match. If you need to make any changes to the captions, just double click on the captioning segment from the text panel, and you can edit it there by typing in new text. So now that the captions are imported, now it's the fun part where you can stylize it to your brand. It doesn't have to be the generic default Helvetica text. It can be anything that you want. So let me show you how that works. Select the first caption, and then you can go up to the Essential Graphics panel and customize the font size. You can use any of the controls that are here to change the alignment or update the faux styles, like if you want to make it bold or italic or something like that. Then underneath Align, I like to use the position controls here to change the alignment in the window in the program panel. Down below, you also have the option to change the color of the text, add a stroke, background, or a shadow. By default, it has a stroke. I'm going to remove that and add a background and increase the opacity so it's more visible against the video. And now here is the awesome part. You don't have to go and repeat this process for every different captioning clip. Instead, you can save this as a style, and the style is automatically applied to the full captioning track, which saves you so much time. Before, this wasn't available in the old captioning workflow. And you can remove this style at any time just by going to the project panel and deleting this style file, or you can right-click on this style file, sounds cool, and you can export it to share it with someone else or save it on your own drive for future use. And then if you need to adjust the timings a little bit more, I recommend using the rolling edit tool. If you press N on your keyboard, you can simply move the cut point between two of the captioning segments to easily adjust that cut point to an earlier time or a later time. Of course, you can always click and move them in any place that you want. And then we're good to go to export. For exporting, there's a couple different options. If you don't want to burn them in, you can go to the ellipsis from the text panel and just export the .srt file as a captioning file, or you can go up to File, Export Media. And then from the new window, you can go to the Captions tab. And here you can choose to burn it into the video or create a sidecar file. And sidecar file is just another way to export a .srt file. I'm going to choose to burn it into the video, and then I'm going to export it. And here is the final exported video with my voiceover in the clips from Videvo. Captions, the way I like to think of it, is reading sound with your eyes and not your ears. And it makes it accessible. Let's take a look at the new captioning workflow in Premiere Pro. PremiereGal.com/captions. I think we can all agree that this captioning update is gonna save us a ton of time with creating our own burned-in captions for social video. And the same technique will apply to both landscape video, like I demonstrated, as well as vertical or square or any type of aspect ratio that you're working in inside of Premiere Pro. Once again, a huge shout out to Videvo for supporting today's video and providing the clips. If you're looking for free assets, they have a great selection to choose from. And if you want to go premium, you can always use my code GAL15 to get 15% off. And now let's go ahead and take a look at this week's product of the week. So this week's product of the week is the Trio Max by Mobile Pixels. They sent this to me. It is a dual extension monitor for laptops. So if you're working on the go or working from home on a limited space, editing or doing design stuff, you can attach this as a landscape mode or portrait mode, or you can use it as its own monitor to just have a better workflow. So if you're doing captions, you can set this up on your laptop and you can see the captions on the side, and it will improve your workflow because you just have more space. I like editing sometimes from my laptop, but sometimes I get hunched over and I'm kind of looking at this one screen. There's not enough space. It's a great option to use this external monitor. It's super handy. And right now, Mobile Pixels just launched a new Kickstarter campaign for their Duex Pro and Duex Lite. So I've put a link in the description to check out this external monitor, Trio Max. It's 14 inches, as well as their other Kickstarter campaigns. So thank you, Mobile Pixels, for sending this to me. I appreciate it. And that's all for today's video. If it helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up, as well as hit that notification bell after you subscribe, because a lot of you don't get notified when I publish new content. And yeah, if you guys have anything else that you have questions about, just leave a comment below. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.